welcome to another edition of The Vote. I'm Bill Smith, and I'm joined today by Sarah Hamilton, who is a teacher at St John's in Brighton, and by Max Cakebread, who is a student at St John's. Yeah. And we're going to talk about autism. Sarah, a lot of people don't know what autism is. What is autism?
Autism is quite a complex condition because it's considered a spectrum condition. So anybody who has been diagnosed with autism might have very, very different symptoms to the next person. So some people, it can be quite mild and sort of manifests in struggling with social communication, not picking up on social cues, and just sort of struggling with that part of everyday interaction with other people. Some people with autism, it manifests a lot, causes them more difficulties in other areas, such as they find it really hard to process sensory. Everything can be quite an overload for their senses. So think background noise that you and I might just block out. So when we're in the supermarket and you can hear voices over the tannoy or other people bustling around or the noise of shopping bags or trolleys, we automatically block that out. But people with autism can really struggle to do that, and it can make day-to-day life quite stressful.
So it's not a disease or an illness then?
No.
It's a disability?
It is, yes. It's a learning disability. Yeah.
A learning disability, okay.
Yeah.
A lot of people, I mean, I suppose in Brighton, there aren't specific schools for it or other. I mean, it's a range of symptoms, I guess, is it? People can go to ordinary schools or not go to ordinary schools. Tell us, how does it affect people when they are diagnosed and what happens?
So a lot of people are diagnosed quite young. So you can sort of start noticing toddlers struggling to interact with other children, perhaps showing a little bit of what we would call challenging behaviour. So struggling to conform, if you like, or follow instructions. And as I'm sure you can imagine, if you struggle to communicate effectively with your parents or with your peers, then it can manifest sometimes quite aggressively. It can be very frustrating for people with autism to sort of get people to understand what it is what they need, that they want from you. So if they're diagnosed quite young, then often if it's quite severe, then they would be recommended to go to a special needs school, somewhere like St John's in Seaford, that's our school site, and then move on through to the college which we have in Brighton. But no, there aren't many places around East Sussex that specialise in particularly autism or Asperger's.
Okay. Max, yeah. What's it like being at St John's with Sarah? How is it for you?
Well, it's not too bad, actually, except I always get things muddled up when I'm trying to go to... On a Friday, I go to Wolfson Theatre.
What do you do in Wolfson Theatre, Max?
I go... It's my workout.
What other lessons do you do at St John's?
I do cooking. And I go to English and maths.
What do you do?
Sounds pretty much like like any other school. Max, you were telling me before that you do swimming and you do skateboarding and stuff. Is that what you really like doing?
Yes, it is.
Right. Have you got any objective that you want to do in your life? Any career or anything that you really want to aim at?
So, well, sadly, yeah. Ken Dodd and Stephen Hawking's have died.
Yeah.
What do you want to do when you leave St John's, Max?
What job?
Sounds like he wants to be a comic scientist.
You would be a very good comic scientist.
Is that what you'd like to be, Max?
Yeah.
So would I, by the way.
What do you tell me all the time that you want to do when you leave St John's?
Go to...
Want to work in a...
baker's shop.
Yeah. And what do you want to do in a baker's shop?
Make food, make bread and cakes.
Yeah. You've got a good name for that, haven't you?
Yeah.
Cake Bread's Bakery.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Works like a charm.
Absolutely. I see that being a big success.
Yeah.
Let's go back to Sarah. So St John's in Brighton, is it the only school, or do you do lots of other things there? Or do you particularly deal with autism?
We take on students with complex needs. Yeah. So autism is the most common diagnosis for a lot of our learners. Yeah. But about three quarters of them have far more complex needs than that. So often autism will be diagnosed in conjunction with other conditions.
Yeah, I see.
And we have three main pathways at St John's: pathway one, pathway two, pathway three.
Yeah.
And the students it just depends on how, because we have lower attaining learners and higher attaining learners. But the goal is, so we're completely self-maintained, yeah, and we have a wide variety of what we call work-based learning areas.
Yeah, I see.
So when the students are referred to us, we sit down and we have a conversation with them about them and their parents and their social workers, about what their aspirations are,
yeah,
for when they graduate St John's. And obviously it's very, very different, just like the rest of us, lots of varying aspirations. And we have to sometimes manage these aspirations and just make sure that we are... So you normally get a three-year programme.
Okay.
And within that 3 years, we try and get them to a point when they graduate that they can be as independent as humanly possible.
What ages?
We take from the school in Seaford, the students are from the age of seven.
Yeah.
And then over at the college, it's sort of 16 to 25, but the majority of our learners are sort of 19 to 22.
So the equivalent of a university sort
it
of
is,
thing.
It is, yeah.
And what I'm gathering, I didn't know an awful lot before, but what I'm gathering is basically... It's a condition, a disability, and people can progress, I imagine, just as in anything else.
Yes, absolutely. Bless you.
Yeah, catching my cold. Sarah's cold.
Yeah, we're all going to have one by the end of this, I think.
Yeah. So is that right? You can progress people just as in anything else, as in school or university?
I mean, it is a learning disability or difficulty, so that there does tend to be... like a period, or you can sort of get up to a certain level, and then a lot of people with autism do tend to plateau.
Yeah.
But as with any sort of learning,
as with me, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd like to think I could be much better in years to come. No,
yeah, everyone plateaus at a certain.
Yeah,
know.
I see. Okay.
But a lot of the focus at St John's is about promoting independence as much as humanly possible and social inclusion, because
we had somebody on a couple of weeks ago, a young artist. Who has autism, but he's got an exhibition coming up, I think at the Phoenix Gallery quite soon.
Yes.
I was talking to people before I did this show, and they said a lot of people with autism are very artistic in many ways. Autism, autistic, artistic.
Yes, I mean, yeah.
Is that true?
Yes, it is. I mean, there's lots of films and things obviously dramatised around that. But autism can, the way that certain people's brains work, I mean, they pick up on details, as I was saying earlier, about like black background noise that we just don't. So drawing from life, for example, we had a student a few years ago that could look out of the window, see a landscape, and then look back down and draw it, and it would be like a photograph.
Yeah.
It's incredible, and it's retaining large amounts of information. So we had a student last year that knew the entire transport system for the South East. You could say, right, I have a meeting in Hastings at 11 o'clock on Thursday morning, how best shall I get there? And he would be able to tell you.
Right.
Yeah, it's quite incredible. Some of the abilities of the students we work with are just absolutely mind-blowing. We've got students that can reprogram computers in the blink of an eye.
What are they doing this later this week?
Yeah, taking over the government.
Yeah.
I mean, it's amazing. It is. It really is amazing. And a massive part of the work that we do at St John's is around employability, obviously, to try and promote independence.
Yeah.
And a lot of that work involves going into local businesses and talking to employers and trying to sort of broaden their horizons a bit, sort of get them to open their minds and realise that a lot of people with autism are an absolute asset to have in the workplace. They very rarely call in sick, as you can see. Max is at college today, even though you've had a bit of a rough week. You've not been feeling great, have you?
Got a bit of a cold. Max, when you said earlier that you wanted maybe to do bakery, but you also like things like swimming and skateboarding and stuff, And you mentioned theatre. Are you interested in the arts? And,
yeah.
Which one particularly do you like most? I mean, I like theatre and films. What
like
do you think?
I like theatre company.
You do? Would you like to be in one?
Mm-hmm.
Start one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And would you like to do that with other people?
Yeah.
You'd like to... You'd like
so,
to...
Yes, but... Yeah. What is epilepsy?
Okay.
You know what epilepsy is. Some of the students have epilepsy, don't they, Max?
What? I know how to spell it.
That's good. You are very good at spelling.
It's E-P-P-E-R-L-E-P-S-Y.
Thank you.
Epilepsy.
What it means. So join us after the break. And welcome back to The Vote. I'm joined by Max Cakebread, who's a student at St John's in Brighton, and by Sarah Hamilton, who's a teacher at St John's in Brighton.
Yeah.
We're talking about autism, particularly about Autism Awareness Week. St John's, obviously that's a school in Brighton. You presumably have to be funded. How do you find the money to do the work that you do?
So we are self-maintained, but we rely on our fundraising department. So we put on some really fun events over the year. For example, we do get quite a lot. Obviously, the parents get quite involved as well. So Max's dad, for example, what's your dad doing this summer for us?
He's going to run in the marathon.
Yeah. So that we do things like that to raise money. And all of the money
What's
that
a
we
marathon?
Raise. So it's a really long race. Really long race. It's
26 miles.
Fast. Yeah.
We can run any speed you like. It's like running halfway to London.
It's a long way. So your dad's going to do that?
I can't do it.
No. Your dad's doing lots of training,
isn't
he?
You're not alone there, Max.
No, I couldn't do it either.
Okay, so if people want to help, want to give you money, how do they get hold of you? How do we find out more about St John's?
Get in touch. I mean, we do have quite an active social media, so we're on Facebook and Twitter at the moment. So it's at St ST underscore Johns.
St underscore Johns, that's Twitter, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep, and you can find us on Facebook as well, St John's School and College.
Mm-hmm.
And we, just give us a call. I mean, my colleague Emma, who works in the fundraising department, she's amazing. She'll quite happily take your calls, any queries. If you want to help out, we have, like I said, events all across the country. Autism Awareness Day, Autism Awareness Week, Autism Awareness Month, which is actually this month. We get quite involved. So today, for example, we'll be doing a walk through Brighton, and nearly all of our students participate. It's amazing. Big sea of blue along the seafront.
Yeah.
How many people would that be?
So we have 86 students in total.
80.
And that's just at the college. So we have the school students as well.
That's in Brighton, isn't it?
Yes, okay. It is, yeah. And it's probably worth mentioning as well that about 50% of our students are also residential with us.
Right.
So we have care homes in and around Brighton where our students live. So we can continue sort of the learning and life skills and independent skills outside of the college educational environment as well. But it's just Autism Awareness Week is just an amazing event, and it is quite big here in Brighton. For example, the shopping centre, Churchill Square, and some other supermarkets actually have Autism Hour, which is where they bring down all of the sensory sort of interference that you often get in sort of those environments and make it a bit more of a friendly place for learners like Max to go and do their shopping.
Yeah.
So no Rihanna.
No Rihanna.
Churchill Square.
No. Okay. It's a Rihanna-free zone.
Max, do you like shopping? Do you like going to Churchill Square? Or
yeah.
You do? You don't find it too noisy?
No.
Or it's okay for you, is it?
Yeah, so at the end of Sugar Babes Easy, we do freestyle and it's really cool because we get to do any move we want.
You do like to dance, don't you, Max?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Mm. Blimey, I feel, wow.
Busy bee.
Yeah. Just going back to your career, are you a specifically autism teacher or were you trained to do other things?
So I work predominantly within the employability department at the college, which is a huge, huge focus, and it's just so important for our learners. I mean, a lot of our guys, you know, they come through the system. We've got learners that have been with us for 15 years, and then, until we developed this programme, it would happen that, so we have 15 years years to try and get these students to a place where, you know,
they can work.
Yeah.
That's what you're looking to do.
Absolutely.
What's the sort of success rate you have? How long have you been doing it, Sarah? Tell me a bit about how long you've been.
About 2 years I've been working
at
St John's. Yes. I mean, we started a pilot project last year where we had seven learners that were graduating, and we did a really, really intense course, employability course with them, where they were doing work experience after work experience, learning about work skills, like transferable employability skills, on the premise that when they left, they would be able to go into paid employment, and six of them did leave with paid employment, and have sustained it. And the statistics actually nationally are 5.8% of adults with autism are in any kind of paid employment, which is unbelievable, really, because everybody that I work with at St John's, regardless of pathway or ability, is employable in one shape or form.
It's great that you're teaching Max and hopefully to get a job.
In the song, right?
Sorry?
You get flipped.
Yeah.
You get lifted up, and then you get flipped over forwards and backwards like a spinning wheel, except you don't. You keep your arms and legs still.
What work experience have you been doing, Max, at St John's? Where do you go on a Wednesday?
Washbrook's Farm.
And what do you do there?
Clean animals.
Well, what's that like?
Not bad, actually.
Do you enjoy it? Do you like farms?
Yeah. Also, when you get flips either forwards and backwards,
yeah.
If you move your when you move your arms and legs, you can end up getting hurt.
Yeah. I'm sure I would.
Yeah, I definitely would
just
too.
Just going back, you obviously teach Max very successfully, from what I can see. Does Max teach you anything?
Yes. Yeah. I mean, I love my job, and everyone that I work with at St John's is of a similar mind. I mean, the learners that we work with are incredible, and they do view the world in a different way to perhaps you or I. And sometimes you learn to look at things in a different way, and you go home and process it, and it's just amazing to be able to work with people that, you know, that are a little bit different. They're just amazing.
Yeah. We had our friend, our television friend, Henry Normal, on a couple of weeks ago. Do you know of him?
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's written a book called A Normal Family, I think it might be called. Correct me if I'm wrong. It is about having a family and a child who is autistic. Mm. He didn't seem to think there were an awful lot of books that told such an optimistic story, as I understand it is. And his son, in fact, is the artist that I was talking about earlier. Are there other books? Are there things that people could look at?
Of course.
Yeah.
I mean, the National Association for Autism have amazing resources online. I mean, the problem is because it is such a wide spectrum, of, you know, for a condition, that it's not one size fits all. And everyone, as with neurotypical people, is different and can present differently. It can be challenging. You know, there are no 2 days are the same. Some of our learners, as I said, it can be so frustrating to not be able to communicate your wants and needs, something that you or I take for granted. So that can lead to them sometimes becoming so frustrated that they end up lashing out. And some learners with really complex needs, really severe autism, it can be difficult to feel like you're getting anywhere. And every now and then they just give you a flash of recognition that they do appreciate what you're doing and that you are making a difference. And if you go the rest of the year without that, then just that one moment is definitely worth it.
Okay, Max. I think you're going to Churchill Square later today. Are you going on a walk? What do you know about what's going to happen later today? What can you?
I have no clue, sir.
Fair enough. You'll be
song.
Following Sarah, yeah.
Yeah,
in the song.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, you brought some.
When you get flips over forwards,
yeah.
Have you? They put your one hand on your back.
Let's talk about skateboarding.
And one hand.
Do you do skateboarding up at the level in Brighton?
Yeah, and one hand on your shins.
What's on the website, Max? What's on the St John's website?
.co.uk.
So what is it called?
St John's... max.co.uk.
And what is there? What's there a video of on there?
Max enjoying his skateboarding.
Yeah. So there's a really cool video of Max doing some skateboarding.
And then when you get in the song, when you get flip-side the backwards, you put they put your hands, one hand on your chest and one hand behind your shins.
You like trampolining, don't you, Max?
Yeah.
Is that trampolining?
Yeah,
okay.
That's so what you did at the weekend,
it's very
isn't it?
Active. Obviously, you like skateboarding and swimming and trampolining. Well, put me to shame, really. Except the only marathons you don't like, but your dad does.
Yeah.
So, good family. What's going to happen later then? You talked about this being Autism Awareness Week and then there's the month and all the rest through the summer. How are you going to keep it in the public eye and how are you going to make sure that you're able to continue the work that you do?
Well, this is what we do. This is so all year round. I mean, it's a brilliant excuse to sort of up our visibility in the local community, Autism Awareness Week or month. But all year round, so we work with local employers, we have partnerships with local companies, you know, other schools such as Hamilton Lodge, other local primary schools, and just making sure that people are aware, you know, it's not such a shock to the system when they see our learners out in the public, and that they just feel a bit more included, really, in the local community. Brighton is incredible for that. We're really, really blessed to live in a city that is so welcoming, and it's amazing to be able to sort of offer that for the learners.
We've got to stop, I'm afraid, now. So thank you for joining us on the vote. Just before we go, Sarah, what was that way that they can get in touch with you?
Okay, so you can go to the website, which is www.saint-johns.co.uk, and we're also on social media as @saint_johns.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Max, for coming
You're
and
welcome.
Telling us about your would-be career and what you're doing now in all those sporting activities. And thank you to Sarah. Join us again on The Vote.